But eventually I got there, and I didn't, when I applied with my friend the first time, I didn't get in, and sadly she got in before me, and she started the program before me. And then the next year, I waited another year and just took extra classes for, you know, bachelor's and just to get some sort of a degree. And then so I finally got in the next year. And I've had some sort of experience. I mean, I've worked as a CNA for like 1 year. And I got some CNA training. And then I worked while I was waiting before I got in. I had some sort of assisted living training and work experience. So I kind of had one up on some of the other students that were in the program, but it doesn't mean that I'm way better. I mean, I did well in like the elderly quarter, but it's totally different. I'm able to like live in delivery and had surge. Those are totally different topics that were stuff that I didn't know about. When I got in, it was I was totally happy. It was amazing. I was excited, and I had to be fully prepared. And I prepared for that, and you do all these, you know, your shots and getting your CPR, and there's like a bunch of shots, and you have to do certain classes, get done before a certain day. And I got in, and the first quarter was chaotic and hell. we didn't automatically go into classes, but we had to visit families and different families and older adult patients, and we had to do interviews with them and get some sort of therapy conversations, and do some of our assessments that we learned in class and clinical. And it was hard because we were with partners. Luckily, my partner was pretty awesome. She was very patient, and we actually lived in the same area. So we were able to collaborate and carpool and stuff. And we had a cool family and an awesome older adult. It made things a little less stressful, but the stress level in the first quarter, I think, is always the hardest for any, like, the first semester of nursing school, I'm sure, for other people in other nursing schools. It's really hard because they totally like attack you or push you with all these classes, and besides that, you have to do these projects and papers. Oh my gosh, papers are a big deal, and those are, you have a ton in nursing school and nursing, the nursing program. And so the papers bogging down, and then just having to fit time in with your family and your older adult that you visited. So that was the first quarter, and then the second quarter came in this older adult. So we were in the nursing home, and that was the first time we were in a clinical setting, and we did concept maps. Concept maps is a whole another deal of stress and anxiety and paperwork. And concept maps, the thing behind that is we get the patient and we have a preclinical day, which is like in the evenings where we find out who our patient is, and we have to fill out this whole freaking packet on data that we find out about our patient, on their diagnoses, why they're there, how they got admitted, what are their clinical medications, what's their history, what meds are they taking, their lab values. I know I'm like pushing all this stuff on you guys, but there's just so much information, and then we're expected that night to fill out all that paperwork and like two diagnosis patterns that we think would be fit for that patient and why they're there. And then let me tell you, those took like all night, and usually we didn't have any sleep. And then the next 2 days are clinical days if we work with that patient, either we're there the next morning or the next evenings. And that if you had preclinical and then clinical day the next morning, that was even more stressful because you were pulling overnighters, and then you would go take care of a patient with like how many hours of sleep, or probably none. So that quarter was really hard, but I got through that quarter, and I thought that, you know, the first quarter was just going to be the hardest, but I think each quarter gets harder. And then the spring quarter, before our summer break, we went into labor and delivery. And labor and delivery is a totally different, is a totally different field. That field is really hard. And before that, they cut it into 5 weeks of peds, 5 weeks of labor and delivery. 5 weeks of peds was easy breathing. It was so simple. And clinicals, we just went to schools and we taught children and talked to kids in elementary schools. And they did a really quick teaching project. I enjoyed that, but it was really easy. But then when we transitioned into labor and delivery, it was a totally different, totally different change. My labor and delivery was extremely hard, I thought. And it was really hard. It was for 5 weeks, and I think for me, it wasn't my niche, and I wasn't very interested in the content. I mean, it was interesting to learn about how to take care of moms and babies and the whole process, but being in clinical, I didn't really enjoy it at all. And I ended up failing. The thing with our program is that if you fail a class with a 2.7 grade GPA or less, you're totally out of the program. You're not in the process. There's also the requirement that we have to pass a dosage calculations exam. And you have to pass in each quarter. Luckily, I passed in each one for that, those 3 quarters. But I didn't pass with labor and delivery, and that was totally devastating. That was like a blow to my ego and to like my career goal and my schooling goal, like my focus. And